creditors while it reorganizes. The Chapter 11 filing lists assets of just under $5 billion and liabilities of $4.5 billion. Exodus also announced it will get $200 million from GE Capital to keep operating during reorganization. Trading was halted Wednesday, but shares plummeted Tuesday on expectations of bankruptcy. The stock closed at 17 cents Tuesday, closing to 100% off its all-time high. Chief Executive L. William Krause blamed the company's aggressive growth strategy and the sudden collapse of the internet economy. Exodus employees had little to say, but remain upbeat.
There was a large employee meeting now, but I can't comment on it.
The only worry we have is that, you know, we don't know if we're going to have work or not.
I was already laid off last week, but these individuals are still working for Exodus.
We got cash flow. We're going to restructure. Move forward. Company's still intact. Supporting customers. Nothing interrupted.
I think it'll give us time to restructure like we need to so we can come out and kick butt.
Joining us now is Jay Adelson, CTO and founder of Equinix Incorporated, a competitor in the co-location data center and content delivery networks business. Thanks for coming in, Jay.
Thank you.
First of all, can you tell us, how does Exodus Chapter 11 filing impact Equinix?
Well, really what's happening out there is any content provider or customer of Exodus or any managed service provider is looking for diversification right now. And so because Equinix is a location where multiple networks participate and multiple managed service providers like IBM and LoudCloud and Sitesmith, they're looking to us as a place to get that diversity.
Does this bankruptcy give you an opportunity to expand?
I'd say it gives us an opportunity. Certainly anybody who's interested in that new form of diversity, networks, internet service providers, I mean companies like Yahoo and Charles Schwab obviously have been focused on this for a long time. So we see more sophisticated companies coming to us with interest.
Can you tell us what the market really looks like here? Cut out the predictions. Okay. What do we have?
Well, a lot of people who are very concerned about their future. Certainly a lot of companies want to make sure that they're stable and that they never get themselves in a situation again where they're locked into one specific provider. Because if anything should happen to them, they need to be able to move. So locating in a geographically diverse situation where they can move a wire and connect to any number of different services is probably a good idea.
Do you think that this reorganization in any way gives Exodus a chance to reorganize and then come back at you?
Well, certainly. I think that there is an opportunity for them to sort of rise from the ashes. But the reality is that you have to think about what the financial people inside all of their customers are thinking today.
Do you think that this filing in any way gives you jitters yourself that your company might be next?
Well, Equinix is very stable at this time, so I'm certainly not worried about going to Chapter 11. Right now, we're just going to ride the course and take these opportunities as they come.
Can you tell me about the main differences between Exodus and Equinix?
Well, Equinix is, the good analogy is sort of like airports and airlines. Equinix is like an airport to the internet, where a number of different services come to interconnect, whereas Exodus is more like an airline. They're one managed service provider. So we're like the airport for the internet infrastructure.
Do you also have a high exposure with dot-com companies?
Not really, and that's mostly because of timing and the sophistication of our different customers. Somebody like a Yahoo is much less likely to disappear.
All right, thank you for joining us, Jay.
It's my pleasure.
Appreciate you being here. Jay Adelson, CTO and founder of Equinix Incorporated.